Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome back to another video on Next.js. In this video, we will see how to fetch data from Firebase Realtime database using React and Next.js application. If you face any issues, then feel free to reach out to me. You can comment here or DM me on my social media handles. The links are in the description below. So without any further delay, let's get started. I started a Next.js app and these are my default settings for this project. My project name is Firebase app. Next, navigate to the Firebase app directory and install the Firebase package using the command npm install firebase. Next, I opened the app in Visual Studio Code and without writing any code, I ran this project using the command npm run dev. Okay, this is the default rendering of the Next.js app. But before writing any code, we will set up our Firebase account. Go to the firebase.google.com and click on Get Started. Then add your project and give your project a name. Follow the video to set up your Firebase account. Now click on the web and register your app. We will use these config keys in our Next.js app. So inside the app directory, create a file and name it as firebaseconfig.js. Copy this and paste it here. Modify the default config keys for the Firebase Realtime database. Now inside the build section, click on the Firebase Realtime database. Click on create database and choose your database location. I also read the rules. Here I wanna go with the test mode. So select the test mode and click on enable. We are all set, but we have to use this database URL inside the firebaseconfig.js file. So copy the URL and paste it into the firebaseconfig.js file. Now let me quickly add some data to our database. We will fetch this data using our Next.js application. My root node name is users. Now head back to the page.js file and delete the default code. I will add a header first. First, we will import all the required components. The first line of the code is use client. This is a directive that tells Next.js to only run this code on the client side, not on the server side. Inside the home component, we are declaring a state variable called users, which will store an array of user objects that we will fetch from the database. We are also declaring a setter function called setUsers, which will allow us to update the state variable. Next, we are using the useEffect hook to perform a side effect when the component mounts. The useEffect hook takes two arguments, a callback function and an array of dependencies. The callback function will run only once when the component mounts, because we have passed an empty array as the second argument. This means that we don't want to run the callback function again when any of the state variables or props change. Inside the callback function, we are creating a reference to a node in our database called users. We are using the ref function from Firebase database, which takes two arguments, the database object and the path to the node. Next, we are using the get function from Firebase database, which takes a reference as an argument and returns a promise. The promise will resolve with a snapshot object, which contains the data at the reference. The promise will reject with an error object if there is any problem with reading the data. We are using the then method of the promise to handle the resolved value. Inside this callback function, we are checking if the snapshot exists by using the exist method of the snapshot object. If the snapshot exists, we are using the val method of the snapshot object to get the data as a JavaScript object. Next, we are using the object.entries method to convert the object into an array of key value pairs. Next, we are using the map method of the array to transform each subarray into a new object. The map method takes a callback function as an argument, which receives each subarray as a parameter and returns a new value. Inside this callback function, we are using array destructuring to assign each element of the subarray to a variable. The first element is assigned to a variable called ID, which represents the unique identifier of each user in our database. The second element is assigned to a variable called data, which represents the user data such as title and subtitle. Next, we are using object spread syntax to create a new object that contains both ID and data properties. Next, we are using setter functions to update our state variable with user's array value. If the snapshot doesn't exist, we are using console.log method to print no data available in browser's console. Next, we are using the map method of users array to render each user card. The map method takes a callback function as an argument, which receives each user object as a parameter and returns a JSX element. Inside this callback function, we are using a div element with some classes to create a card for each user. We are using a key prop to assign a unique identifier for each card, which help React to optimize the rendering process. Now we are all set, but my Firebase data is not rendering here. I have committed some mistakes, I guess. Upon checking, I realized that the spelling of the database URL is not correct. That's why the data is not rendering. So fix this, and now our data is showing. That's it. Now you know how to fetch data from Firebase Realtime database using React and Next.js application. Thanks for watching and see you soon in the next Next.js video.